Let's start with a stat. 62% of organizations that suffered a data breach in 2025 reported that they have no current governance policies in place to manage AI or to prevent the use of shadow AI. Businesses are concerned about the complexity involved in the technical adoption of governance.
But they're just as concerned about privacy and the cost of losing trust with their customers. Clearly, governance and security are closely related. So why are they regularly siloed off from each other? And where do we go from here?
Hi, I'm Betsy Greytok, and I'm Vice President and Responsible Technology Officer at IBM. And with me today is Evelyn.
Hi, I'm Evelyn Anderson. I'm a distinguished engineer. I am also the Chief Technology Officer for Cybersecurity Services and a Master Inventor.
That sounds complicated.
Sometimes it can be. So let's take a moment and talk about security and governance. So how does it actually play? What's your definition?
If you're going to govern an AI system, I think of it as two sides of one coin. One side being the actual policy that the corporation adopts, which should be closely incorporated and account for the corporate strategy. Mm-hmm. These are the people and the processes who are going to make this work. The other side of the coin is the technology behind that to actually track what the systems are doing, how they're behaving, and are they aligning with regulations and core values of the corporation.
Okay, this is very similar to what we're doing within cybersecurity services. For us, with most of our clients, I mean, the foundation is you're looking at the policy. How are you actually controlling not only the technology, but the people that are working actually with the technology? How are you disseminating their roles and responsibilities? And you mentioned privacy. I mean, one of the key things that we absolutely look at from the privacy side of it is how is that model protecting sensitive data?
I get asked all the time, how do I know if an AI model is safe? Or how is an AI system safe? And I found it fascinating, the whole industry discussion around the point of AI safety. With a software program, it tended to be, does this software have a vulnerability and subject to attack? With AI, it's a whole different world.
Yeah.
You have to be concerned with safety around the data, and safety around data can mean many different things to many different people. So it might be, does the data carry a certain bias around it? Is it skewed in one way or another? Does it have sensitive personal information in it? So there's data safety, and then you have to secure the data. You don't want anybody attacking your data. That's just one aspect, and we're at the very beginning of an AI system. Then you move into the model. Is the model safe? And nobody really has a clear definition of when a model is safe and what is safe. Is it subject to cyber attacks? Can it be prompted in such a way to elicit offensive output? Is it performing in an accurate manner, or is it skewed in favor of one group of the population or another? It's something that we're trying to address with a lot of different guardrails.
One of the biggest areas that we've been working is really around cyber resilience. And so then when you threw AI, you know, or Gen AI or agentic AI, it brought this whole new world, you know, of possibilities out there. Because when you mentioned, you know, the question on is it safe, our biggest response is it reliable? Is it trustworthy? And that's one of the things we think about, like from whether or not the AI models are actually scaling. So are they performing the way that we think they should be performing? Do they have latency in it? And that's how we start the conversation with our clients, is everything else, you build the foundation. If the foundation is strong, being your governance, where you have, you know, the laws, the rules of how it actually needs to be managed. And then you have your security, where your security is really testing and making sure it's the guardian. It's the guardian around the entire AI systems.
Historically, you did see a lot of silos in the governance policies. So we have a cyber team that addresses the security of our software products and our hardware products. You have a privacy team that sets the governance around how we collect personal information and protect personal information. And then you had data security, where it was this, how corporations have been housing their data forever, trying to protect any kind of leak, but it was a separate house.
Yes.
You didn't have the cyber security working on the software products, really working too closely mm-hmm. with the data security, mm-hmm. who was protecting data warehouses from attacks. And the privacy team was kind of giving instructions. But AI systems create this epicenter that bring all of this together. Now that you have this epicenter that is putting all of the data, all of the privacy concerns, all of the cyber concerns, and adding additional concerns of what can you do with the prompts and the output, it's creating that whole center that now we cannot operate in a silo anymore. They all have to be joined together, operating at the same time, making sure one does not break the other. So Evelyn, last year, Gen AI was the hot topic. And now everything is about agentic AI. It's not even that it's coming, it's here.
Mm-hmm.
How does that change the world of keeping models safe?
It's really still the same. You still have to have the same foundation. I mean, when it comes to the agentic AI, the whole purpose of it is you want to actually automate. I mean, we want to become better, faster, quicker. This is truly a time where if you think about something as simple as, you know, in the old days, if we wanted to prepare a meal, you put it in the oven, 30 minutes to an hour later, you had it. Now it's pop it in the microwave, 30 seconds later, you get it. So we're trying to find capabilities to where some of those things that is repetitive, especially that we can actually, you know, identify data models that can actually perform those tasks and learn from it. So at least within our world, we're moving forward with the agentic AI, but we're looking at it from the governance perspective. Let's actually work with our clients to install adaptive governance. So whenever they actually implement their rules for their systems, that instead of relying on someone to implement and put in the right configurations to make sure that it's aligning with whatever laws and regulations that you have out there, we're trying to push it automatically so that it's not a person that's doing it. You just run a program, it's working, and then it's designed in a way where it automatically goes back and checks and validates. So we still keep that checks and balance in place where we're auditing as a part of the normal process. But those are some of the approaches, at least within my world, that we're trying to ingest as a part of adaptive governance to support agentic AI.
One of the trends that I've been noticing is around AI regulation in particular. They're coalescing around what IBM established years ago as our principles of trustworthy technology and the pillars that we built underneath those. So the same themes are emerging: explainability, transparency, robustness, privacy, fairness. Mm-hmm. They all come around these same themes. When you've built your governance program around those themes, it makes it much easier to pivot to whatever regulation comes out, because you most of the time you can say, check, I already do that.
In the context of scaling, how does governance and security play into that for you?
No, I see governance as the foundation of being able to scale AI. I mean, the beauty of foundation models and the generative AI is you can take one model and then adapt it to do many different things, much more at a lower cost point. So the ability in the world of economics to scale AI is there. But if you just rapidly start scaling AI throughout your organization, it's going to be running wild with no sort of parental guidance to help keep it in line. So we discussed earlier, the adaptive governance will allow you to take in the many different use cases that are going to occur. And then the other thing that I see with scaling is all of the model providers and all of the different AI providers are giving you more and more tools so that you can scale faster.
Yes.
With new opportunities, new features. Mm-hmm. And keeping track of those features is going to be impossible.
Yes.
If you don't have governance as your foundation of your entire AI program.
You still need to make sure you have security so that it's both trustworthy, reliable, and secure.
I see us embracing AI to judge AI in a more proactive manner. Instead of investing hundreds of thousands of dollars, millions of dollars, and getting to the end of it and saying, this isn't going to work. If you use AI to judge a use case and an idea that you have for an AI system, it can help enable you to fail fast. And you actually may not fail. you may just be able to identify the necessary guardrails and protections that you need to put in place in order to implement the system. So how does that play with what you see as the hot take for next year?
My hot take would absolutely be being proactive. This is where you test, you retest, and you test again. You want to make sure that, you know, from a fundamental, that you establish governance and security at the ground level. You don't build it and then think about, oh yeah, I need to add this, because then you're always, you know, running, trying to catch up. If we're being proactive, if we're establishing the laws, if we're establishing the guardrails, making sure that we've actually fortified our fortress of AI systems, then that's the key for me, is you must be proactive. You can't wait until it occurs. You have to start thinking about all the things that could potentially occur and making sure that you have to think like the hacker. You have to think like them, thinking, okay, here's a little vulnerability that, you know, here's a little gap in their security that I want to see if I can penetrate.
In the world of AI, we're constantly living in a world of, I don't know what I don't know, right? You're always discovering something new. The hacker's going to discover something new. AI is going to do something that you really didn't anticipate that it would be doing. And so I agree with you. You want to be preventive and try to get on top of what you don't know yet. And certainly putting tools in the hands of our clients so that they can investigate that as thoroughly as possible before they put a system into production is what I think the world is really looking at now. I think where AI is headed, there's doomsayers out there who say AI is going to take over the world or replace workers or all the bad things that it can do. But I think we've covered ground here where if you put a proper governance program in place and you think about being responsible with your use of AI, it truly will augment the workplace, makes our lives easier, lead to innovations that we didn't think would happen within our lifetimes. And I really think if you approach it with that manner of responsibility, that we can accomplish great things in the next decade with AI.
It's been great actually having this conversation, talking about governance and security. For me, it feels like my job is just beginning, that I have completely started over. And there's this whole new world that I have to think about adjusting to. So for me, when it comes to AI, I think we've just barely touched the surface.